guys, today I wanted to show you how you can create random notes or generate melodies on the fly in Bitwig without having any idea at all. And we're gonna start off by adding one instrument track, and I'm adding one note echo. This note echo is a MIDI effect and it only generates repetitions on MIDI notes. Okay, so when I'm pressing one key, turn this on. When I'm pressing one key, you see the repetitions appear. And we can, of course, change the timing. I like to have higher times. And we turn the repetitions to infinite. So we're gonna repeat this stuff forever. And of course, we want to have on each step of this echo the velocity not changed, unchanged. And we gonna add one modulator. And this time I take in random and we change the pitch. 1.0 is enough. We change the pitch on each step of this echo. So to hear something, we have to add, of course, an instrument. And I'm taking the polysynth. Let's try it. Press a key. So every step is basically the pitch randomized, which is okay. But we have to constrain it to some scale, and I'm choosing C minor. This is done via the diatonic transposer encoded in Bitwig, so it basically takes each note from this note device and constrains it to one scale, so we can make sense of it musically. And yeah, if I press the key, every note generated is in C minor. Sounds not pretty interesting because the sound is not very nice and the timing is maybe not right. So I'm gonna add some FX, like one delay, a long delay, and I'm gonna add one reverb. And in the wet signal, I'm using one EQ, and yeah, let's try again. That's okay. And yeah, we're gonna start to randomize our sound, so we have each note or each step one slightly different sound. I'm using the random modulator again, changing the cutoff frequency. I'm using a second one to change the octave, maybe two octaves up and down. And yeah, add some voices. And maybe modulate the FX randomly, of course. And let's try again. Okay, that's okay for now. The reason why I like to have larger delay times is to have larger gaps between each step so we can fit in additional sounds in between each step. And this is easily done by just taking this track we just created and duplicate it with Control and D. So we have the exact same copy of this just created track in here, and we can trigger this second track again together with the first track. I'm pressing one key. So we have basically two instruments playing together, and to make it more interesting, we want to change the last track to play a different pattern with different timings and different sounds to make it more interesting. And we're gonna make this by changing some parameters. So we're choosing the last track and maybe change the timing and the speed of the modulators like this. It's a bit slower, different start parameters, maybe a bit higher. And maybe let's change delay times and more reverb. So let's try again. That's much better, and we're gonna try it one last time, because why not? And maybe start even one octave above again, make higher sounds, higher frequencies. Even longer reverb, longer delay, and let's try again. Already see it's pretty much fun to try to generate notes inside Bitwig. It's also pretty easy, and of course because we know this is in C minor, we can add pads to this. Let's try this. One polysynth, add one diatonic transposer just for safety. C minor. Four bars. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Yeah, that's C minor. Let's add delay. And some reverb again. And let's try to add our random generated notes. That's it for today. Don't forget to leave a like or subscribe to the channel. Until next time, see you.